earlier, going to talk about application telemetry and user service. Telemetry is something that came up in previous discussions on mailing lists or previous academies plenty of time. And I think we usually agree that that might be something good to have. For example, to answer questions like how are applications actually used? Right? So in which environment are they used? Can we drop X11 support because everyone's made it already? We don't know. Which Qt versions should we support? We are making guesses there, like how quickly are our updates actually deployed, so which code versions do we still need to support? We don't have any data for this. Which features are actually used in the application? So is it worth to maintain the RoT13 encryption support in Kmail, or is that obsolete by now? We decide that based on gut feeling, but not on actual data facts. Similar for typical workloads, like how many folders does the average Kmail user have? If that's just a dozen. All the features we have to manage hundreds of folders with favorites and search options. At least they probably should be off by default. This is typically something that is heavily influenced by the people working on it and their bias and their use case. It would be nice to have some independent information to decide what to focus on for development, for testing, but also what we talk about, what we show people, like, doesn't make sense to highlight some niche feature that nobody's using. Let's focus on the stuff that is actually relevant. But telemetry alone is not good enough. Because it can tell us misleading or incomplete information as well. Like if the result is a specific feature is unused in my application, is that because the feature is broken, because nobody needs it, because it's obsolete, or maybe people just don't know about it, or they don't understand how to use it, or what it's actually good for. Right? From just telemetry data, we have no idea to decide this. Like it might lead us in the wrong direction. So what we can do about that is ask. So ask the users of our software, or maybe even specifically those not using the feature, why they are not using it, to see if they actually have that use case and don't understand it, or if the thing is unusable for them. We have done a few user surveys in the recent past, and we kind of lack the means to properly execute this. Like we usually promote the service on Bob or Planet.KDE or so, which is at the same time like too wide, addressing all kinds of people, not just the users of the software, even a subset of all users. And on the other hand, too narrow because it's biased towards the people following those media rather than the people actually using the software. So it would be nice to have to ask people inside the application, so the users, or even better, a specific subset of users that we can address this way to participate in service. But of course, all the discussions we had in the past, right, for the subject of privacy. Especially since the telemetry thing has been completely overdone particularly in the mobile apps, where even a simple flashlight app sends your address book to the server just before. So of course, we need to separate us from this, and we, of course, want something that addresses the entire privacy concerns in a way that even we would consider to enable this, right? And that, I think, involves dealing with a number of topics. One is transparency. So we need to make it very clear to the user what data is actually sent, in a way that the users can also understand it. The next thing is control, right? So you want to be able to decide if this is sent or not, or just a subsegment. So you need to find a way to actually select what you want to share in a way that it's understandable. Another common problem with this is unique identification. So is this data that would allow somebody to track what I specifically am doing, right? Rather than just generic information about, say, which Keep version I'm using is that I'm willing to share, but like my exact reading behavior of emails, probably not, especially not getting tied to me. So we need to look at what ways of identification are in the data and how we can deal with that. And the fourth one, I think, is opt-in. So have this off by default, explain to the user why we need this and why it's benefiting, and encourage them to actually enable it. So far, the theory, that's all the nice things we want. That's usually where the discussion in the past stopped. I wanted this for gathering, so I had the motivation to actually start building it. Not just me, especially when it comes to the requirements for what data we want and how we present this to the user. This was done together with Kieran Balazs, some of you might know, who unfortunately couldn't be here. We have actually built something that tries to address those ideas and requirements. And that's the K-user feedback framework. It's not technically a framework yet, but that's ideally where we want to have it in the future. And that consists of basically three main elements. It's a library that goes into the application for providing the data and interacting with the user of the application. There's a server component where the data is connected. And then there's analytics and management tools to set up the product, figure out what data you want to track, and then actually look at the data that comes in. Originally, this was built for the use case gallery, and it's in use there since 2 or 3 months, and already providing the first usable bits of it. Looking at how this works in a bit more detail, on the application side, we have a number of data sources, some built in, some have the ability to have custom data sources, which you can select from which one you actually want to use in your application. The data is submitted in a fixed interval that you add in code. There is the survey targeting. I'll get to that in a bit more detail later. And then you have the ability to configure if you want to participate and to what extent you want to participate. And there's a mechanism to, because nobody would find this in the menu, right? So we try to nicely ask occasionally if you don't have that available yet. But also not at like the first dialogue you see when starting the application, right? So you want to give people time to actually try the application and only then nicely ask, rather than first dialogue is give up all the data. Yeah. provide on the application side. For the data sources, as I mentioned, we have some stuff built in for common information on the environment that might be generally usable, as well as some general application statistics, like how often is it actually used, how long are people using it. In general, we have those four categories, which is also what you can select as a user, what kind of information you want to share. This is basically just a tool to pick from. This is not one by default, so you need to just add whatever sources you find useful. And of course, you can have your own data sources to track specifics, like which feature in your application is used or so. And this is also used for the survey target. So the survey is basically just a URL to some web form, like we have always done it for surveys, right? Just that now the application, well, how you do it in the UI is up to you. The example we have in the library is like a kind of passive pop-up that asks you to fill in the survey if you agree to do this. In the simplest case, just all the users get the survey presented to them. But optionally, you can have the targeting information associated with this, which is basically just a Boolean expression on the telemetry data. So the example down there is multi-screen users on Windows, right? Or you could just ask the Wayland users, or just the users of a specific feature, or people that haven't used a specific feature yet. Anything that you can put in a Boolean expression that has information that is in the telemetry data. An interesting question is, how good is the data we are getting with this? Especially since we don't have the unique identification, so in order to come up with some actual numbers, we rely on the fixed submission interval, and then basically aggregate data in 7-day or 30-day intervals, depending on what you have selected. But then you see how stuff changes over time. One thing you can't say with this is how many users do we have? Because it's all inward, we don't know what the participation ratio is, and we have no unique identification. So if there's two people using it alternating every other week, if your interval is 1 week, for example, or if it's the same person using it every week, you can't tell that at all. I think that's fine, because the absolute number of users, I think that's useful to know for business and marketing reasons, but for development decision, the relative numbers are usually enough. How many people are using a specific feature, that is a percentage, right? I don't know, need to know if this is 1,000 or 1 million. I need to know it's 80%, right? So that's an important feature. The consequences of making this opt-in, I think that is something we don't really know yet. We don't know how high the participation ratio is. We can't even measure that. And we don't know if it has, or if it's giving us a bias on selecting a specific user subset, right? You might exclude the extremely privacy sensitive people who, for privacy related applications, like Gmail with the crypto stuff, would be a very important subset of the users, right? So you need to be a bit careful in what you read into the numbers. But in general, it looks like you can actually get a lot of useful information without having the unique identification. How do we solve the control and transparency part? This is the configuration dialog as we have it in GammaRay, as it's shipped in the library as kind of the reference implementation. You can, of course, do that in various different ways. We also have a bunch of iterations on how to further improve that. But the key part for me is you have the list with all the shared information in a translated human understandable list, basically. If you change the slider, stuff like this is ended or removed. And if you're really curious and really want to understand what that actually means, you can switch to the raw JSON view that shows you the request that's actually sent to the server. Okay, so that is as much transparency as you can have. Compared to, if you look at, for example, how Firefox does this, they just ask you if you're okay with it, but they don't tell you anywhere in detail what they're actually tracking. So I think that is already a big improvement in, towards transparency, and hopefully also convincing users that, I'm fine with sharing this. Like, there's nothing in there that's just being sensitive. So how do you use this in your application? There's a central class that you need to instantiate into your feedback provider. You add a number of data sources to that, existing ones or custom ones. You configure it, also a few parameters on it, which server to use, which interval do you send. And then on the server side, you set up a product for your application. You tell it what data sources you expect, which basically setting up a database schema. Then you wait. Because until you actually see data, right, your latest release action needs to get out there. People need to use it for a while until the encouragement thingy kicks in and asks them to actually enable it. Then they need to actually enable it. And then if you have a week-long submission interval, 2 or 3 months down the line, you might start to get enough data to actually start to draw conclusions. So if you want to use that for kind of like a rapid feedback loop on or like fine-grained changes in the application, that probably has a way too long latency for that. We don't know how quickly our new releases get rolled out. But with the KDE release cycles, I would expect 6 to 12 months for a feedback loop. That's still a big improvement compared to not having it at all, but it's not the magic solution that allows us super agile, measure everything and change and see the impact. You always see the impact of anything that happened in a half or the 4 to 6 months between the last releases. What do we want to do going ahead? So far, this is only a production use for GammaRay running on KDAP infrastructure. So, and there we have less strict requirements for the double privacy and transparency thing regarding that compared to the KDE standards, right? This is a commercial product which you get for free. So, we don't necessarily need to share the results with people. I think that's different for KDE. So KDE should have that on its own infrastructure. And ideally, with a lot of people having access to the data, because that's the other part of transparency, you actually see what we are doing, right? and you can verify that you're not doing anything evil. I don't think we can make it like completely publicly open, because then you would have a web service that is publicly writable and publicly readable, and that just has way too much abuse risk, right? So we probably need to, I mean, it's similar to Facebook. We would need to restrict at least one side of the access, and it has to be read access because we want everyone to find, for example, just to bring the account holders or people who are giving developer rights. There's currently no protection against vandalism or abuse in there. That might become necessary on a widespread rollout. Fingerprinting, so trying to identify users despite there not being any link identifier in there. We actually have seen a few cases already with the OpenGL stack information we have written for Gamma Ray. Some of the versions or vendor informations are incredibly detailed, down to including your kernel revision and the SHA-1 of the driver stack that was built within one release. That is actually a fairly unique combination there. So we have done a few iterations on like trying to strip out these kind of informations and reduce it to a subset that we actually want. Which also helps us because I don't care which exact revision of the Mesa stack you have. I only care if I can use OpenGL 3 or 4 extensions, right? But that is an iterative process, right? We will discover over time that the combination of those data sources is actually too precise for the amount of samples we get, so we need to counter this. Opt-in participation, as I said, we don't really know how high that is, but it seems likely that it is a fairly small ratio. So are there ways to encourage more people to participate without making this too annoying or going away from the opt-in principle? And then I've seen that Plasma is looking into using this. Once we get to a few more applications using it, I think we need to look into system-wide coordination, because we don't want to have like every other app out there bothering you is I want to send data or here's a survey, please fill in, right? So you want to make sure this is there's still enough time between those events for the user not to do over too much. But that should be easy enough to that's it. We have a box session on Tuesday. We have a blog specifically on K-user feedback, so does it provide what features you need? Is it something that we would consider adding as a user? What can we improve? And Plasma has one tomorrow specifically on how to use it in Plasma. That's it.
I guess I can just shout, is that good? I'm interested in the back end. Have you looked at solutions that make data analysis easy? I see there's a bit of PHP code. How do you store data at the moment?
That's something Mirko pointed out as well. My research on what already existed was primarily on the application side, and in this C++ Cube world, there's very little about this. Mobile has tons of options. The backend right now is a PHP script that dumps the stuff in the Xperia database. So all the analytics is done in the management and analysis tool, and that's in a desktop application. Web front end for this is some nice charts would be nice, but that's not something I'm efficient in producing, right?
I recently started something like that, and then I found Grafana, and my worries were solved, except for text answers, but there are existing tools that we should look into combining with this.
Mirko pointed out the same on the flight here already. That's definitely something to do, and I would be very happy to get rid of this PHP server stuff. Perhaps it's a necessity, I need it to solve something. The interface is basically a single REST call with this. Here's a JSON with, I mean, the JSON you saw in the dialog with the data you're submitting, and the answer is, and this is the service I have for you, find out if there's one that your users might still need to take.